start the timer and then press restart.
So our research question was, is the plastic bag levy the most effective way to reduce plastic waste in Hong Kong? Hong Kong's plastic problem. Over the years, the amount of plastic that's been dumped in landfills has been increasing steadily. In 2009, the amount of plastic waste that's been dumped in landfills each day was around 1,700 tons. In 2015, that rate increased to around 2,000 tons per day. Also, plastic recycling, the rate of plastic being recycled in Hong Kong has declined severely, and as of 2015, over 800,000 million tons of plastic waste was disposed of at landfills. The dangers of plastic pollution. Plastic can take up to 2,000 years to fully break down, as it's not biodegradable like other types of waste. This creates a host of different problems. For example, animals and fish have been known to consume or be entangled in plastic debris. This causes them either illness, injury, or death. Even zooplankton, the smallest creatures in our ocean, have been found to consume microplastics. As a result, plastic waste poisons our food chain. Apex predators, such as humans, ourselves, would consume the toxins that have been accumulated in lower levels of the food chain. Furthermore, plastic toxins can seep from beneath landfills into our groundwater. Exposure to such plastic toxins have been linked to many ailments in humans. For example, birth defects, immunity impairment, as well as cancer.
So if you've been to any supermarket or any store in Hong Kong, you will have noticed the government's response in this crisis in the form of the plastic bag levy scheme. The scheme was introduced in 2009, where registered stores would be required to charge 50 cents for every plastic bag requested by consumers. This was eventually extended in 2015 to include all stores in Hong Kong. The purpose of the scheme was to discourage people from using plastic bags and enforce a kind of a no plastic bag or bring your own bag policy. However, since 2009, government waste reports have shown that plastics in landfills are still increasing and have not made any, and the scheme has not made any significant decrease in those numbers. An observational study done by a local Hong Kong NGO, Greener's Action, has also shown that over half of their observed stores are even ignoring the plastic bag levy and are still handing out the bags for free. Because of this information, we are convinced that the plastic bag levy scheme is not the most effective way for Hong Kong to reduce waste, and the government needs to implement stronger and more effective solutions.
So long story short, no, it is not the most effective way, but here are some alternative strategies that our group has come up with.
So one strategy, while not directly an alternative, would be simply expanding the levy. So a new waste tax planned for implementation in 2019 will involve charging 11 cents for every liter sized plastic bag for households. This is based on similar laws in Taipei and Seoul called the pay-as-you-throw policy or the volume-based waste fee policy. For example, in this image, these images were taken in Seoul, and you can see that the trash bins have either payment chips or RFID scanners attached to them, and they would charge each person based on the amount of trash they're placing into the bins. So the pros of this strategy would be that it will allow people to visualize the amount of waste they're producing, and it creates a stronger incentive to reduce waste and recycle more. And because it's on such a much larger scale and everyone's essentially kind of forced to do it, there's a stronger potential for it to create a bigger impact, and it'll be easier for the government to enforce. However, we can't ignore the drawbacks, and since it has not exactly been implemented yet, the future of this law is still uncertain, and it may end up repeating the previous levy's outcome and not being able to reduce waste effectively. Additionally, it may allow people to find other illegal ways to dispose of their trash in order to avoid the fee.
In order to address plastic waste and work towards reducing it, the Hong Kong government must also look towards prioritizing more traditional methods of waste reduction. A major method that can be focused on is the recycling programs and policies in Hong Kong. Currently, the Hong Kong government has imposed waste charging schemes, such as the plastic bag tax, as we have said. However, imposing waste charging schemes cannot lower the amount of waste disposed significantly, unless there's an increase in the amount of waste recovered. And the waste recovery rate cannot increase without waste separation being targeted at its source. According to the EPD figures in 2011, as we said, of the 843,000 tons of plastic collected, the amount recycled was a minuscule of 0.5%. And with figures that low, it shows Hong Kong needs to fix this. Government waste reports from 2008-2015 show the amount of plastic waste relocated landfills increased from 18% to 21%. So despite policies such as the plastic bag tax, waste in Hong Kong has increased. In order for Hong Kong to reduce their waste rate to ensure landfill capacity, they will need to increase their waste recovery rate from 36% to 55% by 2022. Those rates being the recycling rates of successful countries such in Europe as such. In order to do this, Hong Kong needs to renew their recycling priorities, and they must do so soon. Renewing programs in Hong Kong possesses a number of benefits. Recycling has been a long-proven and traditional method of waste reduction, and is used in some of the cleanest countries in the world today, such as Germany, France, Switzerland, and other places in the EU. They are all countries that have recycling rates from 50 to 60%. Recycling and waste management also contributes to the economy. One of the most significant disposal companies in Europe, Baxi, agrees with this. Recycling is a green business. It employs millions of people around the world and contributes $500 billion to the global GDP. And there are those in Hong Kong who believe the government views recycling as a social issue when it can be seen as an economic issue and solve it for their own benefit. Not to mention, by increased funding of the recycling programs for long term, they can increase their landfill capacity for a more sustainable city. Recycling programs, however, cannot be the only solution, as recycling has limits. One of the major reasons the recycling industry in Hong Kong is suffering today, as we heard, is because it's been lacking recycling rate has decreased. It's because Hong Kong's been lacking in waste that is actually recyclable. As plastic waste recycling hit its peak in 2010 at 1.5 million tons, and yet in 2015 has only hit 94 million tons, according to EPD figures. This is because most plastic manufactured and used in Hong Kong are disposable, but they're not exactly renewable. Meaning Hong Kong must look to changing the plastic they use and import, or using ideas such as plasma gasification, which we will talk on later. In order to implement stronger recycling into Hong Kong, the government must invest longer-term funding for recycling organizations to start up. As of now, most of these programs are only temporary and struggle on the funds they make, because the government does not exactly fund them. They have to work on the funds they earn from recycling themselves. Educating the public is also needed due to contamination risks. Biagil, a recycling organization, says there's a large risk of contamination for recycling. As they said, once that uneaten dumpling or unwanted McDonald's burger gets tossed into the plastic separation bin, another recycling opportunity is lost because you can't recycle dirty waste. Hong Kong can also follow countries that have succeeded in waste reduction, for example, Germany, which uses a wide mix of well-funded recycling programs and a number of waste reduction schemes that correlate with that. This combination has led Germany to have one of the highest recycling rates in the world at 66%, and with 2022, the year of our landfills being fully capacitated, coming ever sooner, Hong Kong will need to act in every way possible to reduce their waste.
We also believe that the Hong Kong government should consider investing in the development of new plastic-to-fuel technologies. For example, plasma gasification. So what is plasma gasification? Plasma gasification technology is a process that uses extreme heat to convert household garbage into its constituent atomic elements, such as hydrogen and carbon monoxide. And because we're running out of time, I'm going to briefly go over the uses instead of how it works. So the uses of the synthetic gas that's produced via plasma gasification is really varied. For example, it can be used to generate electricity in turbines, or it can be converted to diesel and ethanol for transport fuel. It can also be further processed as a substitute for natural gas, and it can be sold to industry for other applications. For example, hydrogen Hydrogen is a main key ingredient in fertilizers. There are many pros to using plasma gasification. For one thing, it gets rid of all the end-of-life plastics in our landfills that cannot be recycled any further. It does this through a process that emits no harmful emissions, such as like the ones that conventional incineration produces. Furthermore, it can be seen as an alternative solution or a plan B to recycling. As Hong Kong's recycling rates have been dropping dramatically over the past few years, and the fact that its main market for recyclable materials, China, announced in 2017 that it will no longer be accepting imports of plastic waste, plasma gasification could be a very necessary and viable solution to Hong Kong's plastic problem in the near future. While there are many advantages of using plasma gasification, there are some drawbacks. For example, it is still a very expensive technology, and it can only process small amounts of trash at a time. Furthermore, it's not very energy efficient, as the amount of energy that the gasification plant itself has to use is quite high compared to what it actually produces.
So our proposed solution to solve this problem would be essentially a combination of all three options. For starters, the Hong Kong government should implement the tax on household waste to prevent the increase of plastic in landfills.
Yet they should also promote and prioritize recycling programs to reduce the amount of plastics in landfills and to help sustain the city.
Finally, the Hong Kong government should invest in the development of gasification plants in Hong Kong so that they can help get rid of the end-of-life plastics that can't be recycled any further through an emissions-free process.